So I remember when my husband and I first started dating, and he said to me, "You know, life with me is a bit of a roller coaster. I just really want you to be prepared for that." And I just laughed. I'm like, "Baby, you don't even know roller coaster until you live with me." He believes me now. Yeah. Welcome to the House of Couchie. Thank you so much for coming back. I want to thank everybody who took some time out of their schedule last week to watch my debut video. This is not an easy thing to put yourself out there, and I really appreciate your support in watching, giving the gift of your time to me, and then so many of you complimenting, encouraging me, subscribing, liking, all of the above. Your engagement is really wonderful, and because of it, I'm here again. I'm back for round two. Today, I'm actually going to do a bit of a departure from my haul video that I did last week. I guess it's a bit of a haul video in a sense. I did buy something old, something that requires some TLC. It's going to require a lot of tender loving and care, actually. Yeah, I bought the biggest hunk of junk I've ever bought in my life. So, what did I get? Well, actually, before I tell you what I got, a little bit of the backstory. So, a year and a half ago, I started Etsy, an Etsy shop for House of Couchie, and I'm really excited about Etsy. I'm on there and I'm promoting and I'm doing what all the things that I'm supposed to be doing. My sales are slow coming, I have to admit. I'm not discouraged, but I do find it a little bit challenging to find an audience amongst such a huge community. That said, I think that there's lots of avenues in today's world of internet and pop-ups and appreciation for handcrafted and vintage things. So I started doing markets and last winter, and then I was so stoked about doing some outdoor pop-up store type markets, farmers markets, night markets, that sort of thing all summer. I just thought I was totally ramped. Like, what a great way to spend the summer. Like, I'm gonna be outside, I'm gonna be meeting lots of people. I'm going to be selling all my vintage things that I've found and my upcycled stuff, and it's going to be fabulous. So that was my plan. My very first outdoor market this summer was a night market, and it called for really beautiful weather. And as I'm setting up, this massive windstorm took place.
It's a twister! It's a twister!
Canadians are troopers. There wasn't a tornado warning in the imminent area that we were at, but it was really, really windy. It was all that I could do to keep my borrowed tent from flying away. My clothes were falling off the hangers. I couldn't put my dolls out because they were just like flying in the wind. It was ridiculous. And I was so disheartened. I was disappointed. I was just like, great plan. I'm like, what are you thinking? You're gonna build a business plan for a pop-up shop outdoors in the era of global warming. Good one. Like, total good one. So yeah, the next day I wake up and I'm like totally, rehauling this idea of mine, rethinking how can I do this so that it's, can handle the elements. And 5 days later, I'm standing in the back alley of a stranger, and I am looking at my hunk of junk, my future hunk of junk. And I hear myself saying, I'll take it.
Somebody help me! I'm being spontaneous!
And I, like, later I'm thinking, oh my God, what have I done? So what I bought is a 1977 Vanguard camper van. It's in good shape, but it's also in rough shape. The good parts are that the engine's really good. It's only got 80,000 miles on it, which for the size of motor that it is, it's a V8, that's actually really good. Like, there's more miles to be had, a lot more miles that can be put on that vehicle. The tires are so-so, the brakes are really good. You know, there's some rust on the body, but we're gonna give it a paint job. And the frame, the metal chassis frame of the camper is in really good shape too. And that's a real bonus, that the support system is great. What's not good about it is the camper. The camper it's unusable, basically. A couple of owners prior to me owning it, they decided to gut it and try to restore it. So they've removed all the innards, like the bathroom, the kitchen, the appliances, all the storage, the bedding, everything. It's all gone. All the furniture, everything's gone. But I think in doing that, they realized that there was a lot of wood rot, and including the frame. I think that's what's happened, because they attempted to rebuild the frame and they didn't do a very good job. I don't think that they really knew carpentry, because what they did was the support beams going across the roof, they didn't use a solid length of wood. They used small chunks of wood and tried dovetailing it together. I'm not sure why you would do that for a supporting beam. That just makes no sense. No sense whatsoever. Anyways, when I saw it, the roof had collapsed in from the weight of rain. And in the end, I suggested we strip the whole cabin down, the whole camper part of it, just go right down to the frame, the wheel access and the frames, and rebuild something brand new. And what we're going to rebuild is a mobile store for House of Couchie. I mean, I've been obsessed with tiny house building, and I thought, well, this is perfect for a tiny house to build on it. Why not build a tiny store? That's what we're going to do. So I want to document this process of building this fashion truck for a couple of reasons. You know, one, because although there's a plethora of information on building a tiny house, it is a little bit different building a store, just because there's permit things I got to keep in mind. You know, there's stuff that's got to be in place, and there's also displaying my product that I have to take into consideration, and access of people coming in and out, and lighting, and these sorts of things. So I think that there might be some people who are interested in following this on the business side of it, but also on just like the vintage side of it, like the idea of taking something so old and crappy looking and turning it into something really cool and beautiful. I'm really excited about sharing that with people, because I'm hoping that that's inspiring to other people. And you know, maybe it's not a fashion truck for you. Maybe it's not a mobile store for you, but maybe it is. If I can get a couple of you to look at what you would just normally completely disregard and say, well, that's beyond hope, and turn it into something really fascinating and really usable and maybe really cool. I'm hoping to inspire. I'm hoping to inspire a new way of looking and thinking about old shit.